So today we are going to start a grammar topic that is voice. Okay, voice. I think if you remember, you have already done this thing, this topic, grammar topic, voice. Remember or not? Remember? Okay, so now if you know, then tell me about voice. Why do we use voice? Why do we use voice, and or what is the difference between active and passive voice? One is active, other is passive voice. So what is the difference? Medha, I'll send you the sentences. You need to do those only. Or yes, I think write down the rules also. We are going to discuss rules one by one. So write down the rules. Yes, bache, please tell. Why do we use voice? Or what is the difference between active and a passive voice? Yes. Be quick. Yes, bache, quickly. Nobody? Seventh ki baat seventh mein bhool gaye. Okay. Voice means that a sentence has a subject that acts upon its verb. Passive voice means that a subject is the recipient. Okay, voice for communication. Okay, just see. Now listen carefully. In active, the subject comes first. Correct. This is correct. Active voice, whenever we use active voice, it means we want to emphasize subject. Okay, what we do, we stress, we emphasize the subject performing the action, means the subject is performing the action. Here in active voice, the stress or the emphasis, that is on the subject. Okay, it is on the subject. But in passive voice, the rule is different. In passive voice, the emphasis on object, it is on object. Is it okay? The stress is on object. Got it? It is on object. Means the receiver who receives the action. Or you can say object and the action. Means in active voice, subject is important. The doer is important. Okay? Here, the doer is important. The one who performs, right? And in passive voice, object is important. Our focus, our attention is on the object or the person or the thing who receives the action, okay? Who is affected by the action, okay? So, in passive voice, the focus is on object, or you can say the focus is on the receiver, the person or the thing who is affected by the action, okay? This affected by the action. Affected by the action, and this is the receiver. Clear? Is it okay? Is it clear? And when we see, now it is very much clear that the focus is here, and here in this case focus is on action and the object, right? So when we want to write newspaper reports, okay, when we want to focus, when we want to shift our attention to this part, to the object or to the action, that time we use passive voice. Mostly when we write reports, when we write reports, we use passive voice. Okay, why we use passive voice? Because it will focus on the action and the receiver. That's all. Not on the subject, not on the doer. So when we want to highlight these things, we will use passive voice, and mostly when it is about something happened, some accident or some event, that time the focus is on the action. What happened? And who was the receiver affected by that action? So that time we use passive voice. Got it? Okay, so now can you tell me the structure of active and passive voice? I think this is simple. Active and passive voice in general means one common thing. In general, what are the changes and everything? Anyone? Not related to any particular tense. In general, what is the structure of a sentence that is in active voice and the sentence that is in passive voice? Subject plus verb plus object. Okay. This is in active or passive? Object plus verb plus subject. Right. It is in active voice, we have subject plus verb plus object. As we know, in passive voice, our focus is on object. So this time, we will shift, interchange the places. Okay, what are we supposed to do? We are going to interchange the places. So this way, let me write like this also. This is the doer and this is the receiver. Receiver will come here in the beginning. So it is object. That will become the subject. This is the receiver. Plus, now it is helping verb plus third form of the verb plus subject. Or you can say, let me write like this, plus by plus subject. Subject here is the doer. This is the structure. Got it? Active voice focus is here. This is our focus. Subject. Okay? The person performing the action. Right? So the subject, verb. Now verb, sometimes there is only one verb, that is main verb. Sometimes helping verbs also. Right? So that is why I have written only verb. Clear? Subject plus verb plus object, the receiver. Now in passive voice, focus is here and here. So what is their object? First rule is object, then comes the helping verb. Okay? Helping verb and always third form of the verb. Every time means in any, whatever the tense is, you have to use third form of the verb. Okay? Then by subject. Got it? It is called by agent. It is called agent. Is this clear? If you have any doubt, please ask. In passive voice, the tense can be identified from this part. Because in every tense, we are going to use third form of the verb. Okay? So, from this part, helping verb, we'll find out the actual tense. Is it okay? Clear? Done? Erase kar do? Have you written this thing? Okay. Now, if we talk about the tenses, let's start with the tenses and the simple tense only. Okay? Simple present. first rule for voice is that you are not supposed to change the tense. Okay? Do not change the tense. This is the most important rule that you are not supposed to change the tense. It means if the sentence is in simple present, it should be in simple only. Okay? Because you are not going to change the time of the action, but you are just shifting the focus. Tum sirf focus change kar rahe ho, uska time nahi change kar rahe ho. And if you are not changing the time, then it means there is no need to change the tense. Got it? You are just shifting the focus from subject to object or action. That's all. So you are not supposed to change the tense like you do in the narration. Okay, here no change. Secondly, third form of the verb is used. Okay, third form of the use, form of the verb is used. In passive voice. This is also important. Use of third form. Third form of the verb that is used in every tense. Okay, in every tense we use third form of the verb. Then there are changes in pronoun. That you already know. If there is I, you will change it into me, he, him, she, her. I suppose you remember these because we have already discussed these in narration on also, na? So the changes in pronoun, but there shouldn't be any change in the names of place. The not names of place, like the words that adverbs you can say. Okay, not tomorrow will not change into the next day, the following day. No, if tomorrow is written, you have to use the same adverb. Don't change it. Okay, so I, me, he, him, they, them, it will not change it. Then we, so let's talk about simple present. Simple present. Now just tell me the structure of simple present tense. Simple, a sentence in simple present tense. Subject plus what? How to write a sentence in simple present tense? It's subject plus what? Subject plus S, first form, okay? Subject plus first form of the verb plus object. We'll write subject plus first form of the verb, and sometimes otherwise first form of the verb means base form, right? So sometimes we add S or ES also when the subject is singular. When the subject is singular, we add S or ES. Okay, so subject plus first form of the verb plus object. Okay, subject plus first form of the verb plus object. S, ES. Now if I want to change this into passive voice, first will come the object, means the receiver. After that, as I have told you, that helping verb is important. Here you can see we have only one verb, that is the main verb. But now in passive voice, I need a helping verb. Okay, this helping verb will represent my tense. So here, as it is in simple present, I am going to use is, am, are. Okay, is, am, are. After that, if you see third form of the verb, always, always third form of the verb plus by plus subject, full stop. And we here, it's S-E-S. Now this part shows my sentence is in simple present tense. Okay, is, am, are. Subject plus first form of the verb, sometimes S, ES, object, then in passive voice, it's object plus is, am, are plus third form of the verb plus by plus subject. Okay, now simple sentence, he reads a novel daily. This is the sentence. He reads a novel daily. Change. Active. Change it into passive voice. Okay. A novel is read by him daily. Correct. A novel is read by him daily. We haven't changed this word. Change in pronoun, helping verb, third form of the verb. Got it? And while interchanging the places of subject and object, keep this thing in your mind, that you have to take the articles or adjectives, whatever the things means, whole object. You have to interchange the place of whole subject. Okay, got it? Clear? In case the sentence, this simple present tense is in negative form, that case, subject, when we have negative form, plus do, then we have does, right? When we write the sentence in negative form, in simple present tense, we have helping verbs here. Otherwise, we don't have helping verb. So, in case we have helping verbs, do, does, plus not, plus first form of the verb, plus object, suppose. Now, in this structure, passive voice is going to be object, plus, again, is, am, are. Don't use do or does. Okay? In negative sentences, you have to follow the same rule. Okay, for negative sentences also, you have to follow the same rule. It means object plus is, am, are plus not plus third form plus by object. Sorry, subject. Got it? Is it clear? Now change. he does not cook food. Now change. Be quick. Yes, food is not cooked by him. Food is not cooked by him. Okay, clear? Let's move to the next sentence. Change this. They grow plants. Change this. They grow plants. Plants. Yes, plants are grown by them. Now just check what plants. Plural subject, so we have to change the verb accordingly. Plants are grown by them. Next is simple past. Simple past. In simple past, we have subject plus second form of the verb, right? Subject plus second form of the verb plus object, right? This is the formula. This is the structure, na? Subject plus second form of the verb plus object in simple past tense. See, second form of the verb. Now, object, the rule is same. Object, now in place of is, MR, we are going to use was and were. Was or were. Correct, Anmol. Object plus was, were plus third form of the verb, because this is common, by subject. That's all. Very good. The floor was cleaned by Reema. The floor was cleaned by Reema. One more thing. If name is given, you're not supposed to change it into pronoun. If noun is written, don't change it into pronoun here. And same way, if I talk about negative sentence, subject plus did plus not, first form of the verb plus object, full stop. So this is going to be object plus was. Third form, clear? Change. Naman did not call my friends. Be careful. Here, Naman is singular, but the object is plural. So you have to choose the verb accordingly. Naman did not call my friends. My friends, okay. My friends were not called by Naman. Good. My friends were not called by Naman. Clear? Yes. Same way, if I talk about simple future, can you tell me the change here? What is the change? Instead of second form of the verb, what should I use? Subject plus what? Be quick. Will. No, Punya, only will. No, it's only will plus first form of the verb plus object. Yes, will or shall. Nowadays, shall is used rarely. So that is why I have written only will. So it's subject plus will or shall plus first form of the verb. Right? Plus first form of the verb and object. Here the change is slightly different. It's object plus will plus. Because we don't use third form of the verb directly with modal auxiliaries, right? We cannot use third form of the verb directly with modals. So what we do, we introduce be. That's it. Object plus will or shall plus be plus third form of the verb by plus subject. Yes. Okay. So now, change. Hurry up. The bag. You should know the third form of the verbs, all the verbs, if you want to write the correct passive form. Okay. Now, same way, if I want to write in negative form, here we are not supposed to change anything, just addition of not. Disha will not arrange the books. Now this is in negative form. No, you need to use any other verb, means is, them, are, or was, were. Just add not. Means the books will not be arranged by Disha. okay? Will, then not, then be. Is it okay? Will not be arranged. Clear? Yes, Anve, yes. Write down the rules. You have to write the rules in your peer notebook. Okay? So the time is over.